Now, let's start off with the German Bundesliga this morning. Reports have it that the league is set to return to action with plans to play spectator-free games in May, despite football being on hold across the globe because of the coronavirus pandemic, with all major leagues and competitions suspended. Now, the German Football League, that's the DFL, is determined to finish the current season after its 36 professional clubs met to discuss a restart of the season next month. But before I let Okpe give his own thoughts on this, we have joining us on the show via Skype, Oma Akatugba, a renowned journalist, a German-based international journalist, joining us on the show this morning. Good to have you with us.
Yes, good morning, all the way from Germany.
Yeah,
as we say in German, Guten Morgen.
Guten Morgen, is that how you say it?
Guten Morgen.
Guten Morgen. So I think I need to learn a bit of German right there. But how has it been over there in Germany?
Well, it's like every other part of the world, except that Germany seemed to be on top of the matter. If you've been following the trend, you will know that Germany has a very, very good recovery rate, very low mortality rate, and seemed to be handling the coronavirus pandemic very well. Germany is seen as the model of how to deal with such a pandemic, and that is something that gives us joy.
Yeah, but in the world of sports generally now, what's your own opinion on how the coronavirus has affected this part?
Of course, it has basically locked down the entire world of sports. Mm. It has put the world of sports on a ventilator, just like a coronavirus patient.
Yeah.
Because sport, people's activity. Sport is an event that is driven by, you know, fan fan base.
Yeah.
And the people who are supposed to drive the sports are not able to go out. That makes life difficult for those in the sports. That's exactly why various governing bodies are doing everything possible to see how they can resume football or sports even behind closed doors. And of course, the Bundesliga is taking that lead. Let me not, you know, jump the gun. Perhaps you throw the question before I answer that.
All right, now talking about the German Bundesliga now, we heard that the German Football League have said that the Bundesliga is likely to resume in May. Do you think this should happen? And if it does, what is the process that the German football body is actually taking to make this happen?
Well, normally I would say it shouldn't happen because life matters much more than football. Like some persons have said, it is just a game. Football is just a game. And nothing more. They should not try to push things and you know, face the risk of spreading this pandemic, this virus again, because if this virus peaks for the second time, it will be very disastrous. And we hear that sports could have been responsible for, you know, the spread of the virus, talking about some of those games that were played with fans at the stadium when the virus was picking up. I'm talking about Valencia, Atalanta, Liverpool versus Atletico Madrid. Mm. In Germany, there was Leipzig and Tottenham Hotspur. So, but I haven't followed the Bundesliga and spoken with those running the Bundesliga. I think that they are prepared. They have done their homework. They are ready to play football without the virus possibly spreading. Mm. I've been in contact with one of the guys at the DFL, that is the Deutsche Fußballliga, the organization that manages the Bundesliga. Mm. He's in charge of audiovisual rights, a very key part of the business. And he said to me that in their last annual general meeting, in their last general assembly, I beg your pardon, on the 31st of April, they decided to set up a COVID-19 committee that would be documenting all of the COVID-19 cases among Bundesliga 1 and Bundesliga 2 clubs. They will also be running tests on all the players, you know, prior to games. They are also going to be practicing social distancing. They are going to be limiting the number of people that will be involved in one game. And of course, they went further, you know, to make a plan of buying test kits.
Yeah.
Themselves, where they will be testing every player. So, and that the government approved that, and they said that 322 persons will be in charge of a Bundesliga game, while 270 persons will be in charge of a Bundesliga 2 game. Mm. They will be testing 1,100 players and staff, And of course, they're buying 25,000 test kits. That will be costing them about 2.5 million euros. And of course, certain persons during the games will be wearing face masks. They will be disinfecting their hands, all of the environment. So they put up a proper plan. That means that they will not be risking spreading the virus while the games are on. And the government seems to have approved that. But the CEO of the Bundesliga is saying that whether it's on the 9th or on the 16th, nobody's sure. But what they are sure is that they are ready to play football again in Germany.
Now, it's looking like at the German Football League, they've actually taken all measures to make sure that everything is safe for the players and fans. But do you think it would be...
No fans.
Yeah, no fans. Now, that's what I'm going to. Do you think it would be enjoyable because we'll be having these football games played without the fans? And like you rightly mentioned earlier, sports has to do majorly with the fans, the fan support.
It will never remain the same. Mm. Because football without fans... It's like drinking tea without sugar, except you are diabetic, exactly. You know. And it takes the life out of football. The fans make football the beautiful sport that it is. But there's something we must consider. Football is a big media property. Mm. And that is exactly the motivation behind the plans to resume football amid the pandemic. Because... the major chunk of money that is made by clubs, by football but governing bodies, comes from television money, television rights. Yeah. And they don't want to, you know, they want to avoid a fallout whereby they have to make refunds, and that would be terrible because the television broadcast partners are also asking questions because nobody is sure of where this leads us. So the guys organizing the league, they want to make sure that they fulfill their own part of the contract by playing football, at least behind closed doors. But of course, we remain a television event, which is also very key in this kind of moment. We know that football without a life without football is becoming unbearable for a lot of us because we imagine, you know, imagine life week in, week out, where you sit down and enjoy the very best of football. Mm. So at least, even without the fans, you can still enjoy the game on television. Mm. And that, for those running the games, will be better than nothing at all. Nothing at all.
Mm, very true. And as we go, let's talk about the leagues in general. Now, there are talks on for the leagues now spread across the world to see how they can end the season. Should the leagues actually be called off? Let's use the English Premier League as a case study now. Should it be called off? And if that happens, Liverpool will not be announced as champions. Or should we still hold on to see how we can end the league at a later date?
Well, I would not subscribe to calling off the league. I would suggest to end the league is different from calling off the league. I hope you get my point.
Yeah.
I would suggest you end the league or you find a way of, you know, fulfilling the remaining games, you know, so that you can find a proper winner because you have 9 games to go and somehow, perhaps if things get better before May or June, you can then play the games, you know, hurriedly, you know, in 1 month. Because whether you like it or not, the season must end this year. Because that's also something that is going to affect the UEFA and FIFA calendar of next season. Because the league games, the league matches has, you know, they have a way they affect the European calendar. And of course, UEFA yesterday met with its over 50 member associations, of course, via video conferencing. And of course, they suggested that the leagues should find a way of ending this season so that the Champions League and the UEFA Cup, other games can be played and ended in June. UEFA has tentatively set out, in August to play the Champions League final. And of course, and the UEFA Cup final that will be taking place in Gdansk in Poland. And of course, the Champions League final in Istanbul in Turkey. So their plan is to see that they play the UEFA Champions League remaining games in June, July, and then play the final in August. So they're also communicating with other leagues around the world to see how they can find a way, even behind closed doors, to end the season this year, or this season, as it were. Mm. But of course, we know that Belgium and Holland are basically, you know, thrown in, you know, the towel
said, yeah.
We cannot continue again. For Holland, no football games till, I think, October.
Yeah.
Belgium are basically, you know, ended the league and announced Club Brugge as the champion. So I think also a very key thing that would determine what decision to take is still the television right money. Because whether you like it or not, the broadcast partners will still have 9 games to go. They want to conclude all of that because they pay a lot of money.
Yeah.
For the English Premier League, we're talking about something in the region of £7 billion. This is a lot of money, and of course, it determines how things will pan out.
Wow, interesting conversation right there. So let's bring it back home as we wrap up with the interview. Let's talk about the coach, Gernot Rohr. Should he continue to lead the Super Eagles of Nigeria? And do you rate him as a successful football manager?
Well, first thing first, in 2019, the International Federation for History and Statistics ranked Gernot Rohr amongst the top 20 coaches in the world. That's a very reliable and very credible organization. Mm. And then he went on to lead Nigeria to the AFCON 2019 and ended up with a bronze, losing to the eventual winners. And of course, he took charge in 2016, going back now. And between 2016 and now, he has managed about 38 games. And of course, he's won 21, he's drawn 7, and he's lost 10. A very good win ratio, if I must say. And of course, before taking charge, Nigeria failed to qualify for the African Nations Cup 2 times in a very ignominious, manner. And since then, things have changed. He qualified Nigeria for the World Cup, became the first African nation to qualify for the World Cup after beating Zambia in 2017. Mm. He went to the World Cup with the youngest average team in the world. And of course, since he took charge, he has returned competition back to the Super Eagles. In every position, you have 2-3 players who are doing decently at their clubs in Europe. You look at all of this, you think the man has done a decent job. He's been in charge now for about 4 years, and that is basically the amount of time you need to build a team. I think that we should allow him to continue so that he can consolidate on what he has built. Clement Vestal took charge in 1990. It took him 4 years before he won his first African Nations Cup. I get the feeling that Gernot Rohr is ripe enough, or he has reached a point where he can now win the African Nations Cup. The next Nations Cup in Cameroon, I think, should be that tournament Nigeria should win. I think the NFL should allow him run till that point and see if he can win the AFCON. If he doesn't win the AFCON, then they can say it's time to say goodbye. Because at the end of the day, everything, the bottom line will be, how many trophies did you win? Stephen Keshi won the AFCON. Of course, that's the only thing he did, even though he didn't play the kind of football that I would subscribe to. But he won the AFCON, which is much more important than playing good football. And then Gernot Rohr has done everything right, except for winning a trophy.
Yeah.
But overall, I think he's done a good job, because to win trophies, you have to build a team. Germany built their team that won the World Cup in Brazil for over 10 years after losing the 2002 World Cup, of course, without investing so much in their youth football development. So there's a lot to even winning trophies. But of course, looking at it in terms of what Gernot Rohr has done, I think that he's on the right track. Just give him time, he will win trophies.
All right, just give him time, he will win trophies. Thank you very much for this wonderful conversation.
Always a pleasure. Thank you.
All right, keep it locked down, and of course, stay safe out there. Yes, that was Oma Akatugba, a German-based international sports journalist. We heard his opinion on, he's based there in Germany, and of course, he sees these things on ground. He said the German Football League, they are ready. They are doing everything, putting all measures in place to make sure that the league restarts, and of course, without the football fans. And football is not enjoyable without the fans, but of course, the league has to come to an end.
Exactly. You know, I said it from the inception, since the global pandemic started. Mm. Football and fans is a marriage that cannot be separated.
Yeah.
But, you know, nonetheless, with what is going on right now, people's lives matter the most.
True.
And but football as well has been hurt so bad. But we need to complete these leagues.
Mm.
The top flight leagues, it's incredibly detrimental to them. Mm-hmm. They need to complete these leagues because they've got so much to lose if they do not complete these leagues. Now, first of all, big ups to the German Bundesliga. They've taken advantage of the fact that the German government has done their best so far to curb the pandemic. thankfully, Oma Akatugba said it as well. They have a very low mortality rates. The number of people being infected are also low. Yeah. They've gone back to almost business as usual. We've got shops opened already. We've got people going back to work, although they've advised that most people, if you can work from home, do work from home. So the German Bundesliga have actually taken the right initiative. It's subject to approval from the German government. So if they believe that, you know what, they've got all the test kits that you need, they are going to practice social distancing, and they will do all that needs to be done to make sure that these players are going to be safe. Apart from the players, the personnel also involved. If they are going to be safe, then that's fine. We can go on with football. They can complete their season before the end of June or by the end of June. And then Bayern Munich, Borussia Dortmund, they can continue with the Champions League as well. You know, keeping in mind the fact that the major tournaments have already been slated for next year. No UEFA Nations League, no UEFA Euro tournament. So the players can focus on club football and then go on. Exactly.
All right. A good reaction right there from Opeoluwa Adebari.